scientists were composed of Egyptologists from the Russian Soviet Academy of Science, was sent to Egypt. The fearing that the CIA would learn of this expedition, the Kremlin operated with complete secrecy. By the late 1950s, Egypt accounted for 43% of all the Soviet aid for Third World nations. When they started the ISIS project, the Soviet military personnel in Egypt was estimated over 20,000. The heavy military presence was used to disguise the efforts of the mission scientists headquartered in Cairo. They would operate under the guise of Arab peasants or Russian officers. To speed things up, in 1959 the KGB recruited professional informationalists to wiretap Egyptian officials. This paid off in July 24, 1961, a conversation was recorded that would then change myth into reality. The official had been given a call that two Bedouin had stumbled upon the tomb of the visitor. The Bedouin were in the hospital and kept repeating, "The visitor God." At this moment in time, Project ISIS became top priority and all efforts were made to immediately follow up by having the Bedouin show them where they had found this tomb. SEIFI was able to purchase several documents and film footage as to the KGB documentations of their findings. Taken out of Egypt and brought to the secret facility of the KGB was this memo to high-ranking KGB official. "My agents had secured the notes of one of the scientists working on the tomb of the visitor findings. Another was the inventory of contents taken from the tomb as follows. Location of finding. Undisclosed, 15 crates of relics, 1 partially mummified body, 1 stone sarcophagus, 8 hieroglyphic samples. Old report from a project scientist that was one of the first to enter the tomb. During the inspection of the wall segment, we noted that a strange magnet repulsive force seemed to be emanating from the rock. We were unable to find any scientific explanation. Cryptologist report. Partial decoded message on tomb wall indicating a prophecy of the return of the winged gods." The Kremlin took the cryptologist report very seriously. KGB was ordered to determine target locations, e.g. planets, stars, galaxies. They had to duplicate the stars as they would have been over Giza thousands of years ago. They finally found it, in the stars and constellation of Orion during the year 10,500 BC. Although it was possible that the builders could have been working off plans of a time before the pyramids was constructed, this was proven not to be the case. Metal and synthetic materials of tomb were determined to be of unknown origin and the tomb was carbon dated, giving it a dating of 10,500 BC, meaning the pyramid had to have been made at 10,500 BC. Kinds of film were purchased by SEIFI through the Russian Mafia agent, which originally came from the maximum security archives of the KGB. These kins contain film of KGB filming the process of the tomb and sarcophagus being opened. SEIFI had this film analyzed before purchasing by experts in this field. Finding no evidence of fraud, SEIFI purchased kins of film. The documentary is in black and white, showing soldiers entering the tomb without gas masks. As they opened the sarcophagus, you can see toxic fumes escaping and the reaction of the soldiers as they were being affected. It also shows the mummy contained inside. The film shows the soldiers leaving the tomb fast and then a chemical warfare specialist team comes in with protective clothing. There is talk from one that was there in the tomb, that the energy inside, during the first days of exploration, was very, very high. They also had a team of psychics go in and do some special readings of the tomb. It later goes on to show the KGB and Bedouin loading trucks with crates to be shipped back to Russia. According to KGB documents, researchers began to wonder if the pyramid was actually ancient. Egyptian writings very often talk of beings from the sky opening and bright lights coming down to teach them technology and give them wisdom. Many pictures and symbols resemble UFOs and aliens. Possibly aliens built the Great Pyramid. And these solid long-lasting construction techniques were adopted by the Egyptians. Ancient Egyptian legends tell of Tepzepi, or the first time. This is described as an age when sky gods came down to earth and raised the land from mud and water. They supposedly flew through the air in flying boats and brought laws and wisdom to man through a royal line of pharaohs. And of course, this was all thrown out the window when Christianity came along. Keep in mind that the gods were the one and only religion that there was. No other conflicting beliefs? Why? Well, because it was fact, not faith. The modern church would have you believe that it's just a myth. But you have to ask yourself on the edge of Occam razor, what truly indeed is more likely? There has always been the question. How did the Egyptians feed and care for the 100,000 slaves that it would have taken to build the ancient structures like that of the pyramids in Egypt? One minute it is a very backwards country and almost overnight a highly advanced and technological culture sprung into existence. We now have the answer to that very question and evidence that the Egyptians had help, extraterrestrial help at that, thanks to Russia, the KGB and a top secret project called Project Isis. Astrophysicist, neurologist and science advisor in advanced propulsion system gained access to the files of Project Isis. This was a top secret project brought about by KBG concerning the discovery of the tomb of the visitor in 1961. Up until Sci-Fi purchased this exclusive footage from an agent of the Russian Mafia, it had never been seen outside the top-secret facilities of the KGB. Sci-Fi showed it one time on television, and as it stands today, no evidence of this film or the project is available. Except what we have copies of here given to us by a client that had taped the original show, this video is a powerful documentary with actual footage filmed by the KGB and verified by specialists in the field. Authentic film footage. If we can somehow bring attention back on Project Isis and prove it out, it will change the history of the beginning of the civilization of man. During the Cold War, Nikita Khrushchev was determined to show the world that communism was superior over the democracy. As he realized that it would be too costly to compete with the US in the space race, Khrushchev chose to go the other route. Having over 300,000 agents in the secret police and espionage organizations, he focused most of this resource on alternative science, such as paranormal phenomena, psychotromedic weapons, biogenerators and mind-altering machines. 1920s, during the Stalinist regime, a dark room was created where the KGB conducted psychotronic weapons research on prisoners sentenced to die and political dissidents. After 1936, these files were transferred to the secret archives of the KGB, continuing on with their paranormal research. Khrushchev achieved great success with his biogenerators and machines to alter human minds, which worried, naturally, the United States, knowing that the Soviet Union was there to conquer and overthrow Russia, being that its borders surrounded the largest landmass of the world, had the largest amount of UFO sightings. If they could capture one of these flying objects and reverse engineer it, they could have the greatest advanced aeronautical designs. They got lucky in January 1986 when a spacecraft crashed in Dalgorsk but remained intact. The craft was back engineered and the process was quite successful. But to achieve the most superior advancement in global domination, they went in search for something that was only a rumor or legend. The Chamber of Knowledge in Egypt. If the legends were true, storehouse of knowledge left behind by ancient visitors from outer space was concealed in the Great Pyramid.
In this documentary you will see miraculous UFO footage that has been authenticated by top UFO.
The documentary featured an extensive summary of the footage, the canisters containing the footage, an expert analysis from the likes of Stanton Friedman. One film expert noted in the documentary that the footage came in an old Soviet canister that had information labeled on it that was consistent with info written directly on the film reel. The numbers on the film's header matched the canisters they came. The header of the film had the crest of the KGB on it, and the term for TOP secret is shown in the first few seconds of this footage and image to the right. Having real-looking alien footage is one thing, but including the original film reel canisters means you are extremely close to proving 100% authenticity. This is something that has traditionally lacked in other more popular alien videos, such as the widely known alien autopsy or the alien interview videos. 3. Several KGB documents. In the documentary, several KGB documents are produced to prove the film is authentic, along with credible testimony from a former Soviet KGB operative who claims to know about the event. At first, everyone believed that those debris were part of some novelty aircraft manufactured in the United States or England, said Pavel Klimchenkov, a former KGB operative, but having done some measurements material analysis,
We came to the conclusion that none of the domestic or foreign manufacturers known to us could have produced this apparatus, at least not in the conditions existing on this planet. Along with Pavel's testimony, authentic KGB top secret documents were obtained by the filmmakers. Allegedly costing them $10,000, the documents described in detail a crash site recovery operation of a disc-shaped object and organic remains. Based on the credible testimony, KGB documents, expert film analysis and the general good feeling one gets when watching this interesting crash site video, it is safe to assume that this film indeed may be authentic. What about the autopsy? This footage will be posted in our second part article along with thoughts and analysis, actors, training exercises, skepticism. Some have put forth the argument that an American production crew filmed the footage in March 1998. These claims are put forth on websites claiming to know the truth about this footage. To date, they have failed to show even one current photo of any of the soldiers in the film, nor any statements from the actors that they were indeed only actors in this film. This should be easy to obtain if the footage was recently filmed. Some have put forth the argument that an American production crew filmed the footage in March 1998. These claims are put forth on websites claiming to know the truth about this footage. To date, they have failed to show even one current photo of any of the soldiers in the film, nor any statements from the actors that they were indeed only actors in this film. This should be easy to obtain if the footage was recently filmed. Another theory suggests the film was a training exercise. Yet no one has produced witnesses verifying this claim. One skeptical viewpoint suggests that the object's thickness is far too small to support any would-be alien pilot. The craft's outer edge as seen on the image is only 12 to 36 inches. However, it is not necessarily indicative of the overall thickness of the craft. The image was taken from the only part in the video sequence where the craft's edge is visible, and since the camera never goes behind, there is no way to tell how much depth the craft may have on the other side. Additionally, if you consider the side facing us may be actually be the bottom, we can easily see that this craft can easily fit the traditional flying saucer shape as demonstrated by the below images. In this documentary they claim that, since they only were able to acquire 4 canisters of film, more film footage of this incident is available, such as the entire digging, cleanup, and inside the craft investigation. To this date, almost a decade after it went public, no other videos have surfaced. A UFO crash site allegedly filmed by the Russian KGB in March of 1969 in the Sverdlovsk region of Russia. The footage was later obtained by documentary filmmakers who then published the movie, The Secret KGB UFO Files. A film expert noted in the documentary that the film came in an old Soviet film can and the numbers on the film's header match the cans they came in. The header of the film has the crest of the KGB on it and the term for top secret. An autopsy of the alleged pilot of the UFO is seen in the documentary film. Soviet doctors examined the burned torso of the entity and it is revealed that the 3 doctors died 1 week later all from cerebral hemorrhages. Death certificates are presented as proof. Several KGB documents are produced to prove the film is authentic. Some have put forth the argument that an American production crew filmed the footage in March 1998. These claims are put forth on websites claiming to know the truth about this footage. To date, they have failed to show even one current photo of any of the soldiers in the film, nor any statements from the actors that they were indeed only actors in this film. This should be easy to obtain if the footage was recently filmed. Another theory suggests the film was a training exercise. Yet no one has produced witnesses verifying this claim. UFO aliens may have helped build pyramids of Giza, says Cairo University archaeologist. Head of the Cairo University Archaeology Department, Dr. Ela Shaheen, in December 2010 had told an audience that there might be truth to the theory that aliens helped the ancient Egyptians build the oldest of pyramids, the Pyramids of Giza. On being further questioned by Mr. Marek Novak, a delegate from Poland, as to whether the pyramid might still contain alien technology or even a UFO with its structure, Dr. Shaheen was vague and replied, "I cannot confirm or deny this, but there is something inside the pyramid that is not of this world." Delegates to the Conference on Ancient Egyptian Architecture were left shocked. However, Dr. Shaheen had refused to comment further or elaborate on his UFO and alien-related statements. Down below is 90s The Secret KGB UFO Files documentary, that deals with the fact that Russian had already discovered the tomb of alien humanoid in Egypt and something is beneath the pyramid. The Secret KGB UFO Files documentary interestingly supporting the head of the Cairo University Archaeology Department, Dr. Ilyushin Klaim as well.